is, it's going down to story of survival, and it all started on Facebook. One user posted this picture of Beau left in the middle of the road. Well, luckily, Tamara Hudson saw that post, rushed to find this guy.
Well, the truth is I couldn't rush because I was in Lewisburg. So I started calling people, and I knew I wasn't going to get there until like 10 or 11 o'clock at night. And this was at 2:30 in the afternoon.
Right.
And I'm just going to say it because everybody else think I'm crazy anyway, but I knew that I knew that I knew when I went at 11 o'clock, he would be there. And all I knew was Crossroads. And I turned, stopped the van for just a second, and he walked out from behind a tree.
Oh, and he was waiting for you.
He's the coolest dog ever, and I just feel really lucky that my best friend, Tonya, has him now, and I get to see him all the time.
She adopted him.
Yes, and this poor dog had been on a, he had a jump rope around his neck, and he'd been tied to a pole. He probably only had maybe 5 feet to move his whole life, and he just didn't know how to be a dog. And he's an amazing dog. He's so well behaved. You can tell he's so grateful, but he needs some things to keep him busy.
Right.
And so does my dog, who is a lab Australian Shepherd mix. The Great Dane doesn't want to be busy at all. So I started looking at some ideas, and one of them, Winston loves the sound.
So this inspired our DIY.
Yes.
Pet toys.
Yeah, there's all kinds of goodies here.
Okay, so this is what we're making here.
And this is just, there's nothing rocket science about this.
Plastic bottle.
And this is a knee sock.
And
you can cut that off, either ends, and then I just used some other fabric I had to tie that on. Now, disclaimer, I know a lot of people are going to be upset saying certain fabrics aren't good for your dog. You need to play with your dog while you're doing this and supervise this.
Yeah.
I know my dogs wouldn't eat this, but once he was able to get through to that plastic, then you want it gone.
So make sure you're painting.
And then there's one quick one here with a water bottle, which I think this is wicked fun too. So you take this, drop in some kibble, you tie knots with these guys here.
Okay, so this can just be towels, an old shirt, whatever you have
this
around.
This is really great.
Okay.
If you're going to do terrycloth like I did, definitely wash it and dry it first. You won't have that mess that I have.
Okay.
Then as you're dropping it in there, put another one. So if they start to pull it out,
they'll get little dog treats.
So it will keep them busy. It works their mind. They need at least 10 minutes a day where they're doing something to engage their mind.
Okay.
That is something I recently learned. So
very cool. Okay.
Snuffle mat is the really cool thing that we're doing.
All right, so you bought this at Walmart.
Yes.
This is just like a placemat.
Yeah, well, it's actually the dish mat that goes in your seat.
Oh, dish mat. Okay.
You can also get the heavier duty, like the mats you stand on at like the Home Depot. So, and they're round holes.
Okay.
So what I did is I cut these already at 10 inches for you. I'm going to let you know that this was a lot bigger when I started last night. And when I did the math and realized it was going to be over 400 knots, I cut it down smaller.
You're like,
so you kind of get started. It is the simplest thing ever. And you'll eventually want to work from the back. All you literally are doing is tying knots.
Oh, okay.
After four, about 200 knots, your hands hurt though, because you're tying them really, really tight. So as you're, and you start, you can make a pattern, and you can make it as fancy as you want. What I did on this one, I did these about 2 inches longer than the blue ones and the red ones, just to give them a little bit more, because what you do, you take, you can do this for their feeding. So our Great Dane does eat way too fast, and she kind of, you'll watch her, she kind of gets choked. So you take the kibble and you hide it, you drop it in here, you break up treats, whatever you want to do, and this is their most natural instinct is scent.
Right.
And foraging is what is also incredibly natural to them. So it engages their mind while they're eating, encourages them to slow down a little bit, but they're having fun as well. So
I love it.
You can also,
does it work to make your dog stop bringing their food from the bowl all the way across the room to the carpet where they smash it up?
Well, I would get one of these, but a heavier one.
Okay.
And then if you do make a big one, which I plan on, but take your time, then they can use it to lay on later too, and you can wash them.
You are so awesome. If you'd like to learn more about this morning's projects, or if you have any